The Jacinto 7 processors provide a mix of heterogeneous processing cores. The fundamental benefit of the heterogeneous processing approach is to use the appropriate core for the appropriate task or workload. This results in overall higher system performance for a given power and thermal budget, and also allows flexibility to use appropriate and/or available software depending on the task. In this section, I will give a brief overview of each of the available processing cores on the SoC, including the MPU, DSP, and GPU cores available in the main domain of the device, as well as the MCU cores available in the main domain and the safety MCU domain of the device. The main MPU, or microprocessor unit, on the Jacinto 7 SoC is the ARM Cortex A72. This ARM V8A-compliant 64-bit core would be the primary choice to run application software on a high-level operating system such as Linux. The A72 is organized as a dual-core symmetrical multiprocessing, or SMP, cluster with a shared L2 cache. The CPU frequency is dynamically variable up to 2 GHz to help control power during periods of limited operation in the application. Error correction and detection and parity are implemented on the L1 and L2 cache memories to enable robustness for safety. Memory management units enable virtualized access to SoC memory space and facilitate multiple virtual machines running on the A72 cores. The TI memory controller architecture provides an L3 cache which is accessible to the A72 CPUs. The L3 access is CPU cache coherent, which allows for high performance data sharing with other heterogeneous cores on the SoC without the need for manual cache operations on the A72. The main MCU, or microcontroller unit, on the Jacinto 7 SoC is the ARM Cortex R5F. This ARM V7R compliant core with vector floating point support would be the primary choice to run safety and control-related software on real-time operating systems such as AutoSAR. The MCUs are organized in dual clusters which can operate independently in split mode or as pairs in lockstep mode, where the second core acts strictly as a checker to verify no faults are present on the primary core. This is vital for safety systems to achieve ASIL-D level system tasks. One MCU cluster is in the isolated safety MCU domain, while up to two clusters are present in the main domain of the SoC. All memories support error correction and detection to enable robustness for safety. Memory protection units and region address translators allow control and extension of the R5 safe access into the full memory space of the device in spite of being a 32-bit native processor. The R5 CPUs may execute from internal or DDR memory, but also may execute in place, or XIP, from external flash memory with inline error correction and inline security authentication. These unique features provide massive extension of R5 code space while still maintaining safety and security. The Jacinto 7 SoC features the C71x, which is the next generation of TI digital signal processors, or DSP, cores. The C71x DSP implements a 1 GHz dual data path CPU, which is capable of both 64-bit scalar processing as well as 512-bit vector processing. This enables very flexible processing capability, which yields 4 to 30 times the performance of the previous C66x generation of TI DSP, depending on the specific algorithms being executed. The C71x instruction set contains enhancements specific to vision processing and facilitates efficient support of OpenVX for machine vision compute. The closely coupled matrix multiply accelerator, or MMA, enables deep learning capability as an extension to the C71x instruction set. One key to achieving such high performance effectively is a multi-level cache system. The L1 caches are fed very efficiently from the L2 cache via a dual 512-bit streaming engine running synchronously to the CPUs at 1 GHz. The C71x DSP is also cache coherent with the A72 MPU core, which allows for efficient data sharing between the cores without manual cache operations. Also, thanks to its ARM-compliant MMU, the C7X DSP may access virtualized memory space managed by the A72 high-level OS. The Jacinto 7 SoC also includes up to two instances of the previous generation TI digital signal processing core, the C66x DSP. Inclusion of these cores allows users to directly reuse highly optimized code from previous generation TI SoCs, such as mature vision algorithms, or audio processing algorithms, or digital radio code. The Jacinto 7 configuration of the core, however, runs up to 1.3 GHz and also enables additional error correction and detection on the cache and memory systems. These capabilities were not present on all previous TI automotive processors. It also provides a region address translator, which allows extension of the C66x DSP access into the full memory space of the device, in spite of being a 32-bit native processor. The GPU, or graphics processor unit, on the Jacinto 7 SoC is based on the Series 8XE PowerVR core from Imagination Technologies. The initial device derivatives will support the GE8430 core, which supports roughly 100 GFLOPS and a fill rate of 6 gigapixels per second. Note that GFLOPS are dependent on exact application scenarios, so the best comparative measure of performance for the GPU are standard benchmarks, which TI will make separately available. The GPU supports industry-standard OpenGLES libraries, facilitating use of standard graphics code. The GPU implements frame buffer compression and decompression hardware, which works in conjunction with the decompression in the display subsystem to minimize DDR memory bandwidth in the system. The GPU also has an independent microcontroller core, which manages and schedules hardware resources such as the unified shading clusters. This hardware resource management facilitates security and virtualization by isolating and time multiplexing resource ownership. The resource manager also facilitates quality of service by allowing preemption of lower priority rendering tasks. These features are ideal for automotive systems in which specific regions of the screen may be owned by independent software entities with different security and safety requirements. For example, some regions may contain secure content, or other regions may have higher criticality levels, such as warning messages or graphical indicators.
Thank you for watching this training. For more information, refer to the links shown. For questions about this training, go to the processor forums at ede.ti.com.